Okay, 2 summers ago, I was in Ripon, R-I-P-O-N, Wisconsin. There's an entire playlist on my YouTube, Ripon Child Hunting Grounds. It was 2 summers ago, they were already prepping, okay? They basically had, I believe it was Soros and the gang up there, buying out entire hotels, okay? These little sleepy hotels up there. And putting in there what they were calling migrant workers, okay? So I found this out because I was up there being hunted on the run trying to get families and children out of Newberry hellhole apartments, and I couldn't find a hotel to stay in. And then the construction workers told me why. Oh, we have migrant workers. So suddenly this Whiteyville town is full of Hispanic people and black people hanging out at hotels, cooking outside. Got it. So I went into one of the hotels. It was a Wyndham Hotel, under some other assumed name. $10,000 a month to rent out the whole freaking hotel so they could put their people in there and give them bogus jobs, call them migrant workers, and just let them sit there. And they don't know they're part of a sleeper cell. Then I proceeded to watch and sit in front of the Ace Hardware that's been there, you know, for decades on end. And it had a whole glass front. And they were redoing the whole front of the store. And they were rolling in tar bins, huge tar bins, stacking them 3 high. So it was, you know, a good 10-foot high wall of tar bins in the main street of Ripon, Wisconsin. Really? What are we getting ready for, boys? You guys, it's the Blair Witch Project hunting grounds up there. It's blatant. They got a bucket in the deli of unmarked meat that's human, okay? This is a bubble town out of control. I need a citizen army, okay? I need a citizen army. How much louder do I have to yell? This is Witch and Warlock headquarters, run by Larry Malkow, M-A-L-C-H-O-W, but everyone already knows that because he's running Ripon College. Yeah, Ripon College, he's the director. And then he dances around to fancy social outings. He lives across the street from the cop shop. Yeah, the guy's got pointy teeth, okay? Where I stayed, where I found the ritual bones, okay? Where I stumbled on the Shimura ritual bones. Yeah, that was Larry's girlfriend's house, little did I know. She just happened to be an MK Ultra survivor herself. Yeah, as a child, she saw her mom shoot her dad in the face. So ever since then, she's a little broken, you know. So Larry targeted her so he could have sex with her, put black magic hooks in her, put Shimura bones on the property, have kids boiling bones all throughout this town and delivering them for Larry, and it's not gonna stop until we do something, okay? So watch my playlist for Thanksgiving with your family, because the children are being skewered and stuffed like turkeys, and I know Grandma has to have her little fancy Thanksgiving because she's gotta make memories. Tell Grandma to stuff it up her ass.